a song they said that I sang when I was like 4 years old. Maybe you'll remember. I have some family here. We'll talk about that in a second. But I had to look it up again. But hold on a second.
2 years old.
This is a song that Patti Page made famous in about 1949, so that gives you an idea of my age. That's all right? So I have never done this until I just kind of worked it up the other day. Everybody calls you darling. Everybody calls you darling too. You don't mean what you're saying. It's just a game you're playing. Someday you'll find someone who will play the game with you. You call everybody darling. Love won't come a-knocking at your door. And as the years go by, you'll sit and wonder why nobody calls you darling anymore. That's that. Just a little bit. They said that my aunts and uncles would say, Dave, sing a song. And I said, okay. And I would do that one. That was a big hit, Patti Page. So we're going to fast forward a little bit. We lived in a place at the time called Franklin Canyon, which is kind of north Beverly Hills. Is kind of poor man's Coldwater Canyon. Sorry, Mom. Poor man's Coldwater Canyon. A great place for a young boy to grow up. I mean, I'm telling you, there were hills, you had pop guns, you had BB guns, you saw deer. It was like living in the country. And all of a sudden, a show came out called The Adventures of Davy Crockett. I'll tell you something, I fell hook, line, and sinker. I had to have that coonskin cap. I had the whole thing. And then they had the song, and it was a Disney channel, and it just kept building. And I go, Fess Parker, and he's singing this song. And I look him up, Fess Parker, and I go, listen to this, August birthdays. When was he born? August 16th.
Okay.
19 something. But this is the better part. Then I look up, what was Davy Crockett's birthday? August 17th, my birthday. So, this song I get people to sing on the bus on the way to school. Maybe some remember this. Born on a mountaintop, Tennessee. Greatest baked in the land of the free. Raised in the woods, knew every tree. Killed him a bar when he was only three. Davy Crockett, king of the wild frontier. Davy Crockett, king of the wild frontier. So those two songs, I remember quite well. August 17th. How many August people are here tonight? There are a few of them. Okay, so now we're moving a little forward, and there was a song that was a one-hit wonder for a guy, and I just loved it. And I don't know, I was probably 9 years old, 10 years old, singing it like crazy. And Guy Mitchell, it's called Singing the Blues. Remember this? Anybody remember this?
Yes.
That was kind of meek, I don't know. Well, I never felt more like singing the blues, cause I never thought that I'd ever lose your love, babe. Why'd you do me this way? Well, I never felt more like crying all night, cause everything's wrong and nothing ain't right without you. You got me singing the blues. Well, the moon and stars no longer shine, the dream is gone, was mine. There's nothing left for me to do but cry over you, cry over you. Well, I never felt more like running away. I should have gone, but I couldn't stay without you. You got me singing the blues. Take it. Thank you very much. shine. The dream is gone, I thought was mine. Nothing left for me to do. Cry over you, cry over you. I never felt more like running away. I couldn't go, why should I stay without you? You got me singing the blues. You got me singing the blues. Thank you.
Poor baby.
Carol Leahy. She's got a September birthday. Oh, that's good. I was going to tell you a little bit about my family. I'm the youngest of three. My parents are both older. No, that's a joke. My sister is here, Lynn Cooper, her husband Carl Cooper, my lovely wife Linda. Lynn, my sister, is my older sister. It's hard to believe she doesn't look like my older sister. Fabulous artist. You need to talk to her. She's really great. Kind of partially involves you. So I would be in the car. We moved to Los Angeles, and we were still being carpooled to these parochial schools, right? And, you know, we were cross-town traffic, you know, and I would drive with her. She's in high school, cross-town traffic to these parochial schools, and I'd be in the back seat with all these cute girls, and, come on, Dave, you can carry a tune to the Elvis, sing a song. And I got a little of that encouragement. But this is what I remember from those days. Take a deep breath on this one. Since my baby left me, it's found a new place to dwell. It's down at the end of Lonely Street, it's Heartbreak Hotel, baby. I've been so lonely, baby. I've been so lonely, thank you. I've been so lonely, I could die. Though it's always crowded, you still can find some room for broken-hearted lovers to holler in the gloom. Oh, baby, now. I'll be so lonely, baby. I'll be so lonely. I'll be so lonely, I could die. Colonel Parker, bring me a sandwich, will you? The desk is dressed in black. The prints alone on the street, they're never going back. Oh, well, now, I'll be so lonely, baby. I'll be so lonely. I'll be so lonely, I could die. So if your baby leaves you, you have a tale to tell. Take a walk down Lonely Street, it's Heartbreak Hotel. My baby say, I'll be so lonely. I'll be so lonely. I'll be so lonely. I could die. Oh, thank you very much. Thank you.
All right. So
here we are. We're living in this house in the canyon of Franklin Canyon. I had a little 45 record player. My sister, older, more sophisticated, always had nice taste, especially in brothers. And I was listening to really kind of sophomore basic rock songs on my little 45. She had the 33 and third player, the big web core, playing all these show tunes and I don't know, every Ray Conniff, Rosemary Clooney and Bing Crosby, Frank Sinatra, all this show stuff, and it had an effect. You know, I'd be sitting in my room, I'd hear this,
oh, home where the wind comes blowing.
You know, all this stuff. I'm going, yeah. And I go, yeah. You know, it's pretty good. So I had to include a show tune. This is from probably the greatest musical, I think. West Side Story.
Oh, yay!
Which Steven Spielberg, supposedly, I hope he does it right, I think he will, is redoing as a musical, using the original music, adding a little bit. I can't wait. I mean, there's not a bad song in that whole soundtrack, guys. Anyway, this is Somewhere. Sandy knows this is going to be tough to get through. We've been dealing with the same issue.
That's right. Except for you have a voice and I don't.
There's a place for us. Somewhere a place for us. Peace and quiet and open air. Wait for us somewhere. There's a time for us, somewhere a time for us, time together and time to spare, time to learn, time to care, someday. Somewhere we'll find a new way of living. We'll find a way of forgiving. Somewhere. And there's a place for us. Somewhere a place for us. Hold my hand and we're halfway there. Hold my hand and I'll take you there. Somehow, someday. I see Barry and Jill Smith here. Appreciate it. I see some familiar faces. You know, I asked Jill on the way in, I said, what's it like to be married to Barry? And she said, well, you know, Dave, it's our marriage is kind of like a deck of cards. We started out, we had two hearts and a diamond. And in the end, you're looking for a club and a spade.
Oh, that was good. That was good.
I got a million of them, I tell you.
No, that was really good.
Well. Okay, see, I really don't have a clue as to how long this is going to take. They asked me. I said, I don't know. I didn't really time it. Here's some buzzing.
Yeah, so I'm probably waiting there.
That's better. Let's hope so. You know, some of us are a little older. I don't know if you noticed, but you know, I look terrific. But I'm actually.
I'm not going
to. You're not supposed to laugh at that. Actually, I'm in my 70s, but I feel like a 30-year-old. Unfortunately, there's never one around.
Well, what would you like
to
tell Dave to do?
Okay. Where's the drum roll? Okay. So, what else happened in our lives? You remember this. So, my parents had very good friends in Henderson, Nevada, just outside Las Vegas, right? And Las Vegas was a thing. And we'd go visit them. I'm so sorry. I'd had to get a room in some hotel, and I thought it was magical. There was a place called the Last Frontier Hotel. I don't know if anybody remembers that. This is way back. They had a little western town. It was unbelievable for kids. It was a dirt road. They had a shooting gallery. They had bumper cars. They had everything. And it was a ball. Then they had the big swimming pools with the high diving board. Yeah. I was really... Now they can't do it because of my industry and mainly lawyers. They won't have high diving boards. They took all the fun away. I love those high diving boards. So then we'd go, and occasionally we got lucky. We'd go to one of these shows, right? And my dad would get these tickets, probably cost about $8 to get in at the time. I don't know, but, you know, it was very civilized to go to a show in those days. It's not like going to the Wiltern Theater and standing up, you know, and being in a mosh pit. You're sitting there in these wonderful dinner tables and booths getting served, and, you know, and now all of a sudden Sammy Davis Jr. comes out, and Rosemary Clooney and all these people. My eyes were open. Big band, you know, this horns and stuff. It just blew me away. I loved it. Plus, they had the dancing girls.
Ooh, now we're talking.
But you remember all that stuff, Lynn?
Oh, yeah.
We have pictures of ourselves, right?
Absolutely.
Sitting in the tables. I was one that the table was always, my plate was always clean. Do you remember? Problem. So, this gets back to you listening to the Sinatra albums down the hall, and the guy that really made all that, and I love Sinatra, but the guy that really made all that stuff very cool happened to be your friend, Annabelle Miller's favorite act. She told me, she says, have you heard this Bobby Darin guy? I said, oh yeah. Because he had Splish Splash and he had some of these other songs, you know.
And he had.
But this one put so much cool in swing music that I've been singing it ever since. And even though I didn't play guitar until I was almost 17, really stupid, but. Oh, the shark babe has such teeth today, and he shows them pearly white. Just a jackknife has old Maggie Bay, and he keeps it out of sight. You know when that shark bites with his teeth, dear, scarlet billows start to spread. Fancy gloves, ooh, where's old Maggie Bay? So there's never, never a trace of red. There's a sidewalk, huh? Ooh, sunny morning, huh? Lies a body just oozing life. And someone sneaking around the corner. Could that someone be old Mac the Knife? There's a tugboat, yeah, down by the river, don't you know, where a cement bag is just drooping on down. That cement is just there for the weight, dear. Five will get you 10. Mackey's back in town. Where'd you hear about Louis Miller? He disappeared. Hard-earned cash, and I'm back. He spends just like a sailor. Could it be our boys done something rash? There's Jenny Diver, Suki Tawdry, and Miss Lottie Lane, yup, and old Lucy Brown. Well, those line folks on the right, babe. Now that Mackey's, he's back in town. There's Jenny Diver, Suki Tawdry. Look out for Miss Lottie Lania and old Lucy Brown. Oh, the line forms on the right, babe. Back in town, he's back in town, back in town. But now look at old Mac, he is back.
Thank you. Trying to catch. catch up on some things here.
Fix that curtain.
Okay.
Don't spit.
What's next? I'm checking my time. I want to see how long this goes. I'm proud. Well, I've got plenty of time. But I don't want to overstay my welcome.
Flipping through those papers, you don't.
Wanting more.
You know, many of you know that I'm actually in the in another business.
You
know,
yes, it's not, you are.
What is it?
Yes,
that?
And it's I'm barely still in that business, but I'm in the business.
Boring.
Well, you said it. I didn't. No, it's. I've had a great time doing that. This is more fun. But I've had a chance to interview a lot of people over the years, and I just interviewed somebody last week for a job, a young woman. And I have my special questions that I ask them during the interview. And I said, well, this has been great. I said, let me ask you a question. I said, what do you think is your worst quality? And she thought for a second. She said, I'd have to say my honesty. And I said, well, I don't think honesty is a bad quality. She said, I don't give a shit what you think. So there are only two acts that I ever heard, like on the radio, and that's where you heard everything in those days originally, that ever just leaped out of the radio and just made me go, what is that? And this is the first one of those two. And it literally, well, it changed my life. I mean, it was the beginning of my grades going down. It was all about girls, cars, and guitars. You know, it's all like 16s. You know, it was. But this is, and I've never done this song. I don't think I've ever played this song. But this was the song that was their big number one hit. And you'll remember this. Sudden that group came out and forced me into being in front of that guitar and pick picking up the needle on the 33 and a third. Trying to figure this stuff out. Now you can figure out everything on YouTube and on the computer. It's so easy for guitar players to get good, I say. These days, it really is, kind of. But, yeah, that was it. So I joined a band, or formed a band, kind of. There were two Catholic kids and two Jewish kids from opposite sides. And we came together and formed this band, and it was pretty good. We had a few names that were all bad. One of them was the Uncalled For. Now, that's the Uncalled For. Now, this is not good advertisement, is it? The Uncalled For. But we were Beach Boy fanatics. And I still am. So, and we played, one of the guys' uncles was a guy named Barney Sorkin, and Barney Sorkin had the biggest society band in L.A., and so we would trail after them, and we'd be the novelty act in the break to sing with the band. So one of the deals we did was Sonya Henie's birthday party. And we're doing Beatles songs and stuff. We weren't that good, I'm telling you. We just didn't have a lot of competition. But we had a lot of fun. Barney Sorkin was a big deal. Anyway, see if I can get through this one. Boy, this is one. Oh, I was going to ask her. During I Want to Hold Your Hand, did my mop top shake when I did those? On the Beatles song. As there are stars above you, you never need to doubt it. I'll make you so sure about it. God only knows what I'd be without you. And if you should ever leave me, well, life will still go on, believe me. The world could show nothing to me. What good would living do me? God only knows what I'd be without you. God only knows what I'd be without you. Still go on, believe me. The world could show nothing to me. What good would living do me? God only knows what I'd be without. God only knows what I'd be without. God only knows what I'd be without. God only knows what I'd be without you. God only knows what I'd be. You heard me do that one. I can't get away without it. Yeah. Okay. So.
That's a big close.
So now I'm at, this is still a long time ago. You're probably thinking, God, how long is this going to go on? Now I go to Arizona State. Arizona State University. And I was going to go to Harvard, but I chose Arizona State instead. This is my roadie. Oh, that's my wife. Oh, there she goes.
Water, is there water back there?
Thank you. Boy, didn't I? She's a very unlucky woman, but it's all right. So I joined a fraternity, and I swear to God, one of the reasons I joined it is because they had the best fraternity song in the world. The girl of my dreams is the sweetest girl. Of all the girls I know, each sweet coed like a rainbow's trail fades in the afterglow. Have you ever heard this?
Nope.
The blue of her eyes and the gold of her hair are a blend of the western sky and the moonlight beams on the girl of my dreams. She's the sweetheart of Sigma Chi.
I have heard that.
Now you remember, don't
yeah,
you?
I last longer.
Oh, I thought that would be more recognizable, but that's how we are referring to egotistical. But it was a Sigma Chi. And so once again, we formed a band. We were the college band, kind of.
Water? Sure. Thank you.
There were three Sigma Chis and one Phi Delta. And we were playing in a place called the library. And I remember Dad and you were very impressed. He's at the library a lot. call the fraternity. Where's Dave? He's at the library. Well, good. This was a dive bar. And we held court there. We played every Friday and Saturday. And we had a ball. I mean, it was the only place in town. And we had to come up with a name. So the name, oh my God. So one of the guys is reading an album notes on the Rolling Stones album cover that said, here is the latest Rolling Stones bag of groovies. And he goes, that's it. We're the bag of groovies. And we spelled it weird, though. We spelled it bag of groovies. This is John Green. Remember John? Bag of groovies. BAGAGROOVEEZ. But everybody said, oh, we're going to the live, man, to see the groovies. And we were a thing for about 3 years there.
Oh, that's bad.
So here we are playing at we're playing at the Library Tavern, and we were kicking ass, and we were having a good time. This kind of big, heavyset guy comes up to me on the break one day. He says, hey, I want to talk to you guys. You're a fraternity member. I said, yeah. Can I talk to you about a concert I have in mind? Oh, great. You must do us for a concert, right? I'll come by the fraternity house. So myself and the president of the house, because it sounded kind of important, meet with this guy, Barry Fay. And he says, well, here's the deal. I want to bring a big act to ASU. I can't get him in unless I'm represented by a recognized organization at the school. And we go, oh, really? Now, this is before Woodstock, after Monterey Pop Festival. And I go, well, who's the act? He says, Jimi Hendrix. And I go, you've got to be kidding me. Really? Now, we just seen Jimmy burn his guitar on stage in Monterey Pop Festival. It was the greatest thing in the world. I mean, it's incredible. And so he said, Jimi Hendrix? Really? The Sigma Chi sponsored Jimi Hendrix coming into the old basketball stadium. It was horrible. It was like a high school gymnasium. And one of my big regrets is I never really got to meet Jimmy, and I had an opportunity, and I won't even get into it. But he came in. The Sigma Chi's were supposed to be the security. We're standing right in front of the stage, and, well, we just were blown away by the noise, you know. But that's the second act, besides the Beatles. And when I heard it on the radio, I said, wait a second. What is that? I mean, guitar players will kind of tell you the same thing. Who are the big acts? Most of them will say of my generation, Hendrix, Beatles maybe, Stones. But Hendrix had that sound. So I'm going to butcher one now, but I'm going to ham it up. So God damn it, here we go. And boy, did he ham it up that night. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about, baby. Oh, you know you're a cute little old love me, girl. Oh, foxy. Yeah. And you know you're a sweet little old hard love me, girl. A foxy, yeah. I want to take you home. Do you know how? Yeah, not much, baby. You got to be mine, all mine. Woo! A foxy lady. I see you all down on the the sea. Ooh, Foxy, you know what I'm talking about. You make me wanna, I get up and scream. Ooh, Foxy, yeah. I've made up my mind. Get your haul, baby. Woo! Foxy lady, yeah. Foxy lady. Yeah, you know what I mean, baby. Come on over here.
Oh,
he did a bigger version that day.
Oh, my God. Years, I never would have thought I'd heard Dave Leahy do Foxy Lady by Jimmy Hendrix. So, I'm sorry.
Thank you. Thank you, Sandy. Thank you. Thank
you. In a million years.
So anyway, there's a guy down, so here I'm getting out of ASU in one way or another. And somebody comes down, I was hired on the spot in Arizona to play in a band in Aspen, Colorado. Now, this is the days where a lot of people, they'd get out of school and they would go on a European trip or something, a hitch around Europe. This sounded like more fun.
Yeah.
I got up there and I was blown away. So many good musicians. Some known, some unknown. Even the unknown guys were great. Some of them were 35-year-old. I say, you know, I'm 23 or 2, whatever it was. Burned out players that kind of were lost up there, drinking hard all day and maybe into drugs. And here's Lee. Lee and I were up there together. He remembers coming to see me.
Lots of drugs.
Yeah. That's why I left the next year.
But
this friend of mine, who's a pretty funny guy, he says, I know your humor. You've got to go to the Aspen Inn. We're going to see the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band, who's living up there. But the opener was an unknown comedian. He says, he's very dry, but you're going to like this guy. It was Steve Martin.
Wow.
And so, you know, Steve Martin comes up, you know, with the stuff and the white deal. He says, and I'm going, this guy's not funny. He's just talking. He says, I'm a musician. I'm going to do the incredible shrinking entertainer routine. And he builds it up. That's right. Before your very eyes, we're going to bring the lights down. He builds it up. Turn the lights off. The lights go back on. All he's done is raise the microphone up in the air. I got him immediately. Then he told the story about, since you know, I woke up this morning and I looked at my cat and I said, you know, you and I are going on a vacation. So we went to Catalina. And we went down, we took a catamaran and it was a catastrophe. And he went on like this, and it, you know, first year, come on. And he never quit as howling. And then the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band, who has been a great act for so many years. There's a guy up there that was doing this fingerstyle stuff. And I said, what are you doing? I really didn't know about fingerstyle. Fingerstyle, so you got a thumb pick. You're supposed to play the guitar like a piano. So that this part is kind of like the bass strings of a piano. And the other is, you know, like the right hand. So it sounds more full, right? And he was doing the song. What is that song? He says, that's Deep River Blues by Doc Watson. And I said, who's Doc Watson? And he said, well, he's one of the greats of all time. Blind, white, blind guitar player, singer. And to me, what Doc Watson was, he took all the whine and the scratch out of the voice of some of those country singers and whatnot. He had this warm voice and incredible guitar playing ability. And so I asked the guy, how long does it take to learn how to play like Doc Watson? He said about 20 years. And then I realized now that it takes longer. So then, lo and behold, one of the guys in my band joins Doc's band years later. And Linda and I went back to Merle Fest. Merle Fest was a festival that Doc had for his son who used to play with him, who was killed in a farming accident. And we got to meet Doc Watson. Sweetheart of a guy. He died a few years ago. But this is Deep River Blues. But the reason this is important partially is because of the fingerstyle stuff that is still fascinates me. Because I got those deep river blues. Let that rain drive right on and let those waves just roll along, because I got those deep river blues. Well, now my old gal, she's a good old pal, but she looks like a waterfowl when I get those deep river blues. There ain't no one to cry for me, and the fish all go out on a spree when I get those deep river blues. Take it. She'll float because I got those deep river blues. I'm going back down to Muscle Shoals. Times are better there, I'm told, because I got those deep river blues. Well, if my boat sinks with me, well, I'll go down now, don't you see, because I got those deep river blues. Now I'm gonna say goodbye, and if I sink, just let me die, cause I got those deep river blues. Cause I got those deep river blues. Finger style, magic. Okay, so now you have to bear with me a little bit because I brought a fancy little guy here. I'm going to play it. Now, I couldn't get it to work with the pickup. It has a special pickup. I think you're going to be able to hear it. We'll talk about why. Hold on. Maybe in the case, a black case on the counter here. You know, Carol Leahy is, I would say it proudly, that she and I have some of the same traits. And as you can tell, she's trying to get up on stage right now.
Yeah. Yeah. Bring her up.
I'm proud of you, sir.
Well, thank you. I'm proud of you.
We're all proud of you.
How about Carol coming down all the way from L.A.? I mean...
Yeah.
And our wonderful helper, Ryan, who's our family. We love him very much. Can you hear this?
Yeah. Tell us about that guitar.
That's the idea about this guitar. So, with orchestras in the 20s, they got very large. And there was always a guitar player in the band. But the guitar player to sit in the front, because you can't hear those wooden guitars, with horns over his head, coming out, you know, he couldn't be heard. They had not invented the electric guitar. So the Doper brothers came up with this idea. Now this is built on a 100-year-old design. It's a 1990s guitar, but it's still built on that. It's a resonator. And the idea is, it wasn't warm, but it was loud. So with no amplifier, listen to this.
Doesn't that come out?
Yeah.
Pretty good. So I can probably play playing it without the pickup. You have to listen. See, but what happened was 10 years later, they invented the electric guitar. So these guitars were worth nothing. So who picked up these guitars? All the black blues players. They would get them for $5 a piece. And they got a slide in their finger, and they made magic out of them. This morning, feel around for my shoes. You know about that, babe. Got them walking blues. Woke up this morning, feel around for my shoes. You know about that, babe. Ooh, I got them walking blues. Leaving this morning, had to go ride the blinds. I've been mistreated, don't mind dying this morning. I don't mind dying. Walking blues ain't bad. It's the worst old feeling I ever had. People tell me the walking blues ain't bad. It's the worst old feeling, ooh, this poor boy ever had.